It's not gonna be awkward. It's not gonna be awkward. Couple of weeks ago, I dropped my very first short film here, without a crew, no budget at all, just me and my girl. Now, my mind is blown away. No more mind here. Only after 2 weeks, it has more than 100,000 views, which is really big. Usually, short films don't do well on YouTube. Can't thank you guys enough for that. Now, there's a lot of comments about the colors in the video, how I color graded, what exposure, what picture profile. So, that's the best time for a color grading tutorial. So, let's start with this one. First of all, we're gonna find our best looking frame, aka our hero shot. So, I think somewhere around here. Yeah, that's good. That's good. So we can have a small portion of the cab on the left side too. Then I'm gonna create three nodes here and put two of them down. Click on the last node and go to effects and type color space transform. I shot this one with Sony A7IV in a SLOG 3 and a SCAMET 3 Cine. So for our input color space, we're gonna choose Sony SCAMET 3 Cine. And for input gamma, we're gonna choose Sony SLOG 3. Now our log footage converted to Rec 79 and it's already looking good. And with a quick look at the parade, we can see it's too blue. Quick tip guys, always remember your shooting settings. I'm gonna rename the code quickly and then we're gonna start with our exposure. So there's an incredible option here in DaVinci Resolve in HDR panel. Just click on the 3 dot here and then input your recording setting here again. SCAMET 3 Cine and SLOG 3 and that will work exactly for your camera setting. Because you can't shoot RAW with any of Sony cameras right now internally, I think that's the best way for fixing our exposures. And because I overexposed my shot almost two stops when I'm shooting SLOG 3, we're gonna bring down the exposure a lot here. Almost 0.7 for light. Then we're gonna bring down the shadows a little bit too. That's good. Somewhere around here. And a little bit for the dark too. Yeah, that works for me. Maybe a little bit more. Then we're gonna create two more nodes for our main look. Nope. Not that. Okay, two more and there we go. We're gonna fix our white balance first of all here and get rid of all those blue, and we're gonna make it another kind of blue, more cyan than blue. Quickly name this one too. Let's click on this node and go to the primaries here. We're gonna bring down the blues first of all here in offset wheel because that's gonna affect all mid-tone shadows and highlights. I think that's good. Then we're gonna bring down the greens a little, somewhere around here. Yeah. Also take a look at the parades while you're doing it. Let's see a quick before and after. Yeah, that's a lot better. Then we're gonna go to the log wheels and play with the midtones. Just click here and we go to the log wheels. Most of the time midtones directly affect the skin tones. We're gonna take down the blues a little and slightly bring up the reds, very slightly. I want the whole shot to be a lot warmer, so we're gonna go back to HDR panel and do the same things all over again and bring down the temperature to almost 19 or 100. Yeah, I think, yeah, that's a little bit too much. Yeah, that's good. I'm gonna play with the tint too, more towards the green, maybe somewhere around 2-220. Yeah, that's good. Then we're gonna go to hue versus saturation and bring up and bring down some colors directly. We're gonna come back to hue versus hue a little bit later. Now we're here in hue versus saturation and we're gonna click all the colors below to make points for every color. First of all, I'm gonna bring up the cyan. Let me see. Oh, okay, I'm on the right note. So we're gonna bring up the cyan a little bit, not too much, and then we're gonna bring up the blues a little bit more. Now it's not gonna affect the skin tones or other colors, just the blues and cyans. Then we're gonna bring up the reds a little bit, not too much. Yeah, somewhere around here is good. And a little bit of the yellows. Let's see a quick before and after. A little bit more of the blues maybe. Yeah, that's pretty good to me. Then we're gonna back to hue versus hue and do the same things. We're gonna create the infamous orange and teal look. So we're gonna turn yellows something close to orange. Click here and slightly pull it up. Very slightly, that's gonna affect a lot. Don't go heavy on this, it's gonna break the footage. Now the cow looks a lot better. Then we're gonna go to the cyans and we're gonna make it a little bit more like green, greenish. The blues too. These parts are very optional. You can do whatever you want. Literally everything that looks good to your eyes. Me personally, I really love this look. Let's see a quick before and after. Looks good to me. But the skin tones are really not that good yet. We're gonna fix them later. Now we're gonna go to hue versus luminance, and that's basically the brightness of colors. You can make them dark or bright. Let's create the points again. Now I want yellows to be a little bit brighter. Not too much, just a little. I think here is good. Then we're gonna go to the blues and cyans. We're gonna play with it to see which one looks better, brighter or darker. I shot this at a cloudy morning, but we can make it a little bit darker to looks like it was blue hour, somewhere around 6 or 7 p.m. if you wanna be super specific. That would make it a lot moodier. I like that. Take a quick before and after, and yeah, that's a lot better in my opinion. Now let's click on another node and we're gonna fix our skin tones here. I'm gonna bring down the reds a little bit, maybe a little bit more, yeah, somewhere around here. Then we're gonna bring down the greens too, not too much, somewhere around 24, and we're gonna bring down the blues too, but slightly. And then we're gonna create another node before that, and we're gonna go a little bit deeper in this one. So let's go to the offset bill again, and we're gonna bring down the blues a lot here now. So it will be more green than blue. Yeah, somewhere around 22. Yeah, that's good to me. And the red's a little bit higher. Not too much, somewhere around 32 looks good. No, that's too much, yeah. That's the best. Now the background is a lot more greener than what it used to be. Maybe we should put down the opacity a little bit. Not too much. Yeah, that's good. Now most of the work is done, and from now we're just gonna add a little bit of sauce on it. Thanks for bearing with me and my voice for this long time, and believe me, I wish I had British accent too. Let's create another node, and I'm gonna name all of them fast. Okay, so quickly for the next node, we're gonna select the eyedropper, and in hue versus luminance we're gonna bring down blues to make it a little bit darker. And then we're gonna create three more nodes above. Then we're gonna click on the third node and we're gonna make a power window just around the face to make it pop a little bit more. And then we're gonna soft the edges a lot. Then we go to the curves and we're gonna make it pop. Yeah, something like that would be good. Then we're gonna track our mask forward and reverse. I'm gonna remove the last node, then right click on the power window node. Add node, outside node, and that would invert our power window. Now we can make everything look darker, so the main focus be on the face. A quick before and after. Now let's bring down the opacity of this layer a little bit, so it won't be too obvious. And then we're gonna add the grain. So go to the effects, type grain and drop it on the node. And I'm gonna choose 35 mm. If we can zoom, you can see what it does. Maybe not on YouTube, but definitely you can see it on your screen. Then we're gonna create another node before that, and in here we're gonna use a little bit of noise reduction here. It's not too noisy, but sometimes it makes the footage look better. So we're gonna go to the motion effects and put the frames on 3. Better. Almost 6. We're gonna break the chain and put the chroma up to 8, and we're done. I think we're done. Let's see a quick before and after. So this is it. I think it looks pretty good. And if you want to see it better, that's our Rec 709, and that's our graded version. We can do some small tweaks at the end too. Messing with the blue and cyan saturations. And add a little bit of curves to maybe make it look a little bit more contrasty. As I said, color grading is so optional. You can literally do whatever you want, as long as you like it. And right now I think it's really done. There's nothing more to do. Let's see what we've done. Okay, I'm just gonna show you one more example here. That's the log version. And after Rec 709 conversion, as you can probably see, this one looks terrible. So bad, literally unusable. It's one of those situations that makes you think, nope, that's it for me. Never gonna touch a camera again. But we can recover that. So now we're gonna go a little bit faster for this one. Starting with a log conversion and creating the four bass notes. This one was on Sony A7 IV II, so same exact settings. So after that, you can see how horrible this is. Too much red that makes her head look like a pumpkin. So after fixing the exposure in HDR channels, we're gonna go directly to saturations and white balance. And with the amazing colors in 10-bit videos, we can save this shot. By a quick look at the parade, we can see we should bring the red down and bring up the blues. Then we're gonna bring down the colors separately by using hue versus saturation in the curves to get rid of all that disgusting yellows. I want this shot to be a lot like it was from a horror movie or something like that. A lot of blues and desaturated yellows and oranges. And most of the time blues lean towards greens in horror thrillers. So that's what we're going for. And this whole mess happened because I lit the scene with power tubes. And they were so close to the subject. And I didn't use external monitors back then. And in that situation, you can't see the Rec 709 version. So when you're shooting log, having an external monitor with the ability of dropping log conversion on would be a huge game changer. I don't want you guys to be bored, so I'm gonna speed up the video. But if it was too fast for you, feel free to bring the speed down. It's just simple tweaking, but it takes a lot of time. Especially when the Rec 709 version is too messed up. But it's 80% similar to the previous shot. And it depends on what look you're going for. But in the custom curves, we're gonna do something a little bit more different. I wanna add a little bit more contrast, but I don't wanna affect the saturation of the color. So at custom curves, we're gonna break the chain. And by clicking on the chain icon, red, green and blues will not be affected. So it's the best for creating contrast. Then we're gonna go and make everything a little bit more darker, but the face. We're gonna track the mask at the end. At this point it looks so much better. It's almost done. We're gonna add a little bit of mid detail and a very light noise reduction. It's not that noisy. I'm sure it's gonna look a lot noisier on YouTube, but believe me, it's not that noisy. Then I'm gonna add two nodes at the end. And after the conversion node, and I will bring some grain. 35mm would be good. I think the skin tones are still too orange and not as realistic and moody as I want it to be. So I'm gonna add another node and bring down yellows and the whole brightness of the image. And maybe messing with the blues a little bit more to be a little bit more green to get that horror vibe. I'm gonna go back and play with the curves too, the custom curve. Maybe a little bit more brightness on the midtones. And yeah, it's done in my opinion. It's 1,000 times better than before. Just look at the before and after. Okay, that's it for me guys. I'm gonna wrap the video here. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to hit the like button. Subscribe, be around. Maybe we could do another one of these. And this time for photos. See you all in the next video.